You've worked hard. You've done your duty, saved your pennies, and now it's time to think about retirement. But before you let loose, you may have critical questions. How can I pick the best plan for me? Where do I go for the right information? What are the tools to make my money grow? Strategy, information, solutions, and advice from qualified credentialed professionals. Joe Anderson and Al Clopine of Pure Financial Advisors have the answers to your retirement plan. This is Your Money, Your Wealth.
Welcome to another edition of Your Money and Your Wealth. My name's Joe Anderson. I am a certified financial planner. Thanks for tuning in each and every Saturday right here at 11 o'clock. I believe it's 11 o'clock, 11 to 11:30 on your Channel 4 cable station. And as always, I'm with the big man, Big Al Clopine. He's sitting right over there. We got a fantastic show. Great show. You got to praise to the Big Al. We got a good show. A lot of things we want to cram in once again in a quick half hour. A lot of confusion, markets, all-time highs. We had a little volatility. Now people might start freaking out. Our memories are so short when it comes to the overall stock market and your money that fear and greed drives us to make terrible, terrible investment decisions. So what I want to get into is some mistakes that you are making as a baby boomer. You've been around for a while. Hopefully, you can stop making the same mistakes. So let's dive in. Let's see what's on my mind today. All right, here's the thing. A lot of concerns. There's top concerns by baby boomers, people that are approaching retirement, or for those of you that are in retirement, is there going to be another market correction? It seems like every time you turn on the TV, you read the newspaper, markets are at all-time highs. Is there going to be another market correction? Now, people have to create their own retirement income because it's the demise of the pension plans. Most of the baby boomers don't have these large pension plans. Also, looking at healthcare, you have to keep up with healthcare costs. It is driving prices through the roof. Do you have enough money to make sure that you can take care of yourself or your loved ones? And then also, of course, Big Al's favorite topic, taxes. People are not looking at taxation when they get into retirement because I'm telling you, that will be one of your biggest expenses, of course, if you saved any money. So speaking of taxes, let's bring on my partner, Big Al Clopine. We got a lot of things to talk about, so.
We do, and taxes are one thing that boomers, baby boomers are really not considering. And when you think about it, there's really five probably roadblocks right now that we're gonna go over on this show as far as the baby boomers are facing. And the first one really is that they're not really considering their goals. And what I mean by that is taking a look at what you're spending, figure out what you wanna spend in retirement, figure out how much money you need to retire, and see if you're on track. Number two is there's a lack of knowledge and how to get this done. Really, how much do you need to save? When can you retire? When should you take Social Security? There's a lot of misinformation out there. And that leads to stocks and investments and a lot of inappropriate investments. What we see is a lot of people that have too much risk, meaning they have too much in the way of the stock market versus safe money. We see other people that have not enough risk. They're not taking enough risk to keep up with inflation. So there's problems there. Certainly taxes and inflation are something you got to consider. Here's something to think about is $100,000 spending today in 20 years is going to be about $180,000 at a 3% inflation rate. And then finally, procrastination. Even if you have the other first four things covered, if you procrastinate, it really doesn't matter. And Joe, we see this over and over again with baby boomers.
Well, no one really wants to pay attention to it, right? It's the summer, Al.
It is, yeah.
I don't want to talk about taxes and inflation and then knowing that I might not have the knowledge to do all the things that I want to do. And when it comes to knowledge, that's what this show is all about, is really to help you get the knowledge that you need to make really good decisions with the money that you have. First thing that you have to do is set up some goals and then get the right knowledge so that you can accomplish the goals. Make sure that you're in the appropriate investments for what you're trying to accomplish. Is it for retirement? Is it putting kids through school? Is it just for wealth transfer? Making sure that you're set up appropriately. Do not forget about taxes. We're going to dive into tax planning again today. And then, of course, you've got to take action. So, you know, if you've got five frogs and they're sitting on a log, three decide to jump off, how many are left? I'll give you a second. Think about it. I know it's a difficult question. The answer is five, because they're just talking about it. It's the analysis paralysis that blows people up. They know that they got to take action, but it's very difficult for them to do so.
Yeah, absolutely. And really, the thing about this is there's a lot of steps. And unless you're trained how to do this, on how to kind of figure out your own retirement, it's daunting. It's how do you go about this? And we know that there's a lot of people that are behind. You look at the baby boomers, and Joe, the average baby boomers, and really it's about 60% of the baby boomers have less than $100,000 saved, and you look, it's about 48% have less than $25,000 saved, and it's just not going to be enough.
So look at those numbers. You got 60% of baby boomers, all right, that have less than $10,000 saved, or $100,000.
Yeah, $100,000.
And then what, 30,000 or 30% have less than $10,000 saved?
Yeah, and about 25% have less than $10,000. So it's really kind of scary.
So when you think of the stats and you look at the numbers, here's what you have to consider, is that a lot of you might have to go back to work. And so when you're looking at work, there's a lot of different things that you can do, right? You can do things that you can enjoy, maybe work at the country club. You might want to consult. You might want to look at different avenues. We have a clip of what a few retirees, they had to go back to work, and then this is exactly what they did. So Ty, if you want to roll that clip.
We're Sergeant Pepper's baby boomer men. We're hippies and we're growing old. Sergeant Pepper's baby boomer man is just as bad as you've been told.
The first thing we consider was something you can't fake. Just listen to the noises that your body starts to make.
Wow. There you go. See, I mean, you can do anything that you want in retirement. It looks like those guys are having a good time. I don't know how much money they're actually going to be making with that.
Would you buy that their CD?
I would absolutely not buy that CD.
I'd buy it.
Yeah,
it's my generation.
Because you are a baby boomer.
Because I'm a baby boomer.
That was
right.
That was awful. I mean, that was hard for me to listen to, that 30 seconds. I think Ty played it 30 seconds too long.
Yeah, it could be.
But with all kidding aside, some of you might have to take a look at going back to work. And there's some things that you can do that's outside the box in retirement. So if you're a little bit behind the eight ball when it comes to retirement, there's things that you can do, all right, such as a lot of retirees are like joining the Peace Corps, if you will. They can travel, they can volunteer, they can find fulfillment. There's so many different things that you can look at. Instead of the traditional retirement, I'm saying here, I need so much money saved, and then I'm going to play golf every day. I'm going to do this and that. Trust me, a lot of times when we deal with retirees, they say, you know what, Joe and Al, I can't wait to retire tomorrow because I'm going to play golf every day. And then 2 months later, we see them, and they're bored out of their mind. So we're going to go to break right now. When we come back, we got a true-false question, and then we have a great offer that we want to dive in to give our viewers. So last week, we had a huge response when it comes to our Social Security Analyzer. It's even better this week, so don't go anywhere. You're watching Your Money, and it's your wealth.
Baby boomer man, it's just as bad as you've been told.
The first thing we consider was something you can't fake. Just listen to the noises that your body starts to make.
It's close to midnight. Something evil's lurking in the dark.
Welcome back to the program, folks. Show's called Your Money, Your Wealth. My name's Joe Anderson. I am a certified financial planner, CFP professional. Right next to Big Al Clopine, he's a CPA. Thanks for tuning in each and every Saturday, 11 to 11:30 on your cable channel 4. Best money show on cable channel 4 from 11 to 11:30, I might add, as well.
On Saturdays.
On Saturdays, yes. Oh, nice. Sound effects. Hey, let's go back to the true-false question. Let's see how our viewers did.
All right, here we go. I should collect my Social Security benefit at the earliest possible age because the Social Security Administration is running out of money.
That would be false.
That would be false.
Well, I mean, that's a I guess, an idea of some people. They're taking it right away at age 62 because, hey, they don't know, is it going to be around? Should I take it right away? Because maybe it's just full of IOUs. This is not a political show by any stretch of the imagination. We take the facts and we relay them back to you. So right now, there's about $2 trillion sitting in the trust fund, according to the Social Security Administration. The money is slowly draining, though. There's more money coming out than going in. And right now, I think the projected date when everything is exhausted, Big Al, is what, 2033?
2033. And actually, to really kind of put this in perspective, most people take their Social Security at age 62, the earliest of ages. And that's a problem, because if you look at a married couple age 65, there's a 50% chance that at least one of you is going to live to age 92. So if you're taking your benefits early, that means you're going to get a lot less Social Security income over time. And that's why this is really a problem. Now, Social Security can be fixed. It's had problems before. They have fixed it. All they need to do is raise the retirement age, raise the limits on how much they collect on wages. That will happen over time. So I wouldn't worry too much about
that. Well, and
that's
all they need to do. Right, just raise the limit. So the younger generation has to continue to pay a lot more.
You need to do that for me because I'm older than you.
Right, I see that. Yeah, you're welcome, by the way. You're welcome, no problem. Well, the baby boomer generation is by far one of the best generations. We've seen the likes of Big Al Clopine's a baby boomer. How about little Michael Jackson?
you're a big guy,
yeah. Right? And so with that, the baby boomers are getting a little bit older. So we have a little clip of where they were and potentially where they are now. And this is just a joke, so don't get all upset.
We're baby boomers, the original rebels. Used to smoke pot, but now we drink green tea. We tripped on acid, now we have acid reflux. We're in the ARP. We was spoiled, pushy, wild. But now we're born to be in.
And of course, that is not true for most of the baby boomers, but maybe some.
Yeah, I have a little acid reflux sometimes.
I know. You sit right next to me.
How can I help it?
Yeah, I can hear it. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Hey, well, let's kind of dive in. Here's some mistakes that the baby boomers are currently making with their money. And so what we want to do is just kind of lay things out. And then at the end of this segment, what I want to do is give a great offer for all of you that are watching that you don't necessarily want to miss. But first and foremost, if you're looking at accomplishing any goal, you want to make sure that you set the goal, right? It's very difficult to accomplish anything if you don't set it. 60% have really no idea what they need to save or have accumulated when it comes to their overall retirement. This is from the Employee Benefit Research Institute. They take a look and they survey a bunch of people and they're like, all right, well, do you have a plan in place? What's going on? Al and I's experience, we've done thousands of assessments. We've met thousands of you over the years in taking a look at, all right, well, here, are you mapped out? We feel that probably only 10% of individuals have a true written type of plan to say, this is how much money I need to save. This is how much money that I need to have accumulated. Here's my tax strategy moving forward to make sure that I can mitigate tax. Here's what's going to happen if something happens to my spouse. And here's what happens if there's a long-term care stay, whatever. You want to make sure that you map this out, you have some goals, because if you have the goal in mind, if you write it down, you're much more apt to accomplish it.
Yeah, well, there's no question about that, Joe. And really, when you think about it, if you drive anywhere, do you drive there without a map? And the answer is no. You want to have a roadmap to figure out how to get there, how much to save, what your rate of return should be, what kind of investments that you want to be invested in, right? When can you retire? When should you take Social Security? All these things should be mapped out for you. And I'll tell you, if you will do this, and it really doesn't matter how old you are, 20s, 30s, 40s, baby boomers, even past retirement, if you have a plan and you know what you're doing, you're much more likely to be successful in retirement, and that's the key. And a lot of the baby boomers really don't have a good plan. And Joe, that probably brings us to our next roadblock, which is lack of knowledge, really.
Yeah, and there's a lot of roadblocks that people are trying to face, right? And then it's just overcoming them. And you have to identify them first. So lack of knowledge. There's a lot of different things that people are doing. Like we've talked about, they're not saving enough. I mean, on average, most Americans are not saving enough.
Right.
People are retiring too early. They don't know, all right, well, here, I'm done. I'm burnt out. I'm 65. I want to get out of my job. Or I'm 62 or 60. And they don't necessarily know how much money that they need to provide a retirement income from the assets that they've accumulated.
Yeah, absolutely. And they're also taking their Social Security too early. And this is a big problem because Social Security, as we actually talked about in our last show, is up to really about 50% of your income for about half of you. Now, for some of you it's less, some of you it's more, but it's a big chunk of your income. And Joe, when it really comes to lack of planning, it also is the fact that I'm going to have to figure out how to make and do my investments properly. And there's a lot of misconceptions on the market and risks and how much risks that I should be taking.
Right. I think when people invest, it's looking at maybe a hope strategy. They don't necessarily know risk and return relationships. I think they have a good understanding, but they truly don't understand, all right, well, what asset classes should I get into? How diversified should I be? People buy what they know, what they're familiar with. If I live in Atlanta, you know, I'm heavily weighted in Coca-Cola, right? If I live in St. Louis, what do you think I'm heavily weighted in? You got it, Anheuser-Busch, even though that is not a U.S. company anymore. So it's a lack of knowledge of the overall markets. We're going to spend several different shows of educating you how the markets work so you can make really good decisions with the money that you have and take the appropriate types of risks. People are taking not necessarily the right types of risk. It's more of a redundant strategy. They're not necessarily diversified. They're paying too much money in fees and they're not managing their assets towards their particular goals. So there's just a lack of knowledge in general when it comes to, all right, well, what do I do? How do I put all this stuff together? And I'll tell you why. A couple of things is that there's such a huge conflict of interest in the industry of financial services. It's like every time you watch TV, you read the paper, you find another individual that is getting busted by the SEC, shutting down for doing something illegal or maybe doing something that's not in a fiduciary standard. Our firm, Peer Financial Advisors, we are true fiduciaries. We have to do absolutely what's in the best advice for the client. So be careful out there. That's, again, why we do a radio show. Al and I have been on the radio for almost 10 years. We're doing this television show trying to get you the information and education for you to do this stuff on your own for most cases. If you need some tidbits or some different information, that is key. So here's what I want to give. All right. Right before the break, I told you that I'm going to give you an offer. Here is the offer that we're going to give you today. We're going to give you a free financial assessment. If you want to sit down with a fiduciary that is a fee-only registered investment advisor that does not sell any products, and on top of that is a salaried-only employee of Peer Financial Advisors, they're not compensated by any commission whatsoever, we will give you a full assessment at absolutely no cost. So we'll go through soup to nuts of everything that you're currently doing. We'll look at your Social Security strategy. We'll take a look at your real estate, your debt, your retirement plans. Do you have Roth IRAs, Roth conversions? Are you on track for retirement? Are you not? The list goes on and on. You can sit down. It's a 50-page document. Sit down with a true professional to get unbiased advice and use this as a sounding board. For our viewers today, everyone that calls can come into our office absolutely free. 888-994-6257. That is the number to call. 888-994-6257. I take advantage of it. It can get you in the right direction or at least point you in some different areas where you might want to look at that you maybe never looked at before. All right, we got to take a break. When we come back, we're going to still dive into some of the roadblocks that people are making with their money. We'll talk about taxes. I'll make it to the whiteboard. Well, if we have time, we'll answer some email questions. There's a lot more to go. Do not go anywhere. Show's called Your Money, Your Wealth. We got another true false question coming up right here.
Etch-a-Sketch, the toy you'll never tire of.
You'll love it, and so will your youngster.
It'll take time, I know it. Just to have a little scene. When I say we'll be cool, I think that you know what I mean.
We're bringing back the 60s for you, for the baby boomers.
It takes me back.
Does it really?
It takes me back. I think I had most of those toys.
Played a little mouse trap?
I still use that to sketch at night sometimes.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Is that where you do your taxes?
My main plan. tax planning.
Yeah. Right. In April, don't touch the extra sketch.
Yeah, because I got all my calculations
right
in there.
Oh, honey, you moved it. easy on the old laugh track.
I think it's not that funny.
It's not that funny. So.
Yeah, that's more like
it. Man, this show's just turned to cheese. But. Anyway, hey, welcome back to the show. Show's called Your Money, Your Wealth. My name is Joe Anderson. I'm with Big Al Clopine right here. Thanks for tuning in each and every Saturday, 11 to 11:30 on your cable channel 4 station. If you ever want to listen to Big Al and I on the radio, we've been on the radio for close to 10 years. We're on about two or three different stations here in San Diego on 760 KFMB, 10 to 12 Saturdays, and then, 10 to 11 on KRLA up in L.A. So you just can't get enough of the Big Al Show.
Not to mention podcasts on our website.
Oh, now he's...
Now I've really opened it up.
Yeah, now he's really plugging everything. So now I guess I got to plug some. If you would like to come into our office, what we're doing is giving away a free financial assessment. That is for everyone that is watching this program right now that feels that, hey, maybe I might want to sit down with a professional that I can get unbiased advice from. We're a fee-only registered investment advisor. What that means to you is that we do not sell any products. What we do is give advice. And for everyone that calls this show today, you can sit down for a couple of hours and we'll go through your overall situation for you at no cost, and we'll tell you all the things that you're doing good, all the things that you're doing poorly, and areas where you might want to take a look at to make sure that you can get from point A to point B a little bit more effectively. So we'll look at your taxes, we'll look at your investments, we'll tell you how much money that you're paying in fees, if everything's appropriate, if everything is gelling together for you. You take that information, implement on your own, do whatever you want with it. That's our gift to you. If you want to take advantage of it, call the number that's on your screen, 888-994-6257, 888-994-6257. Another thing, if you want to go to a true-false question that we asked, let's go to the true-false question.
All right, here we go. I shouldn't have to worry about income taxes in retirement because I'll definitely be in a lower tax bracket.
Well, I mean, I guess that all depends.
It depends, but I mean, for a lot of people, that's false, and here's why. Because at age 70 and a half, you have to take your required minimum distribution. You have money in 401ks, you have money in IRAs, and you have to take those distributions whether you want to or not. It starts at almost 4% of your account, and it grows from there. And if you add that to your Social Security and other pension income, other investment income, maybe a rental income, many of you are going to be in actually a pretty high bracket, maybe even as high as you are before working. I'm not sure if that's a hallelujah or not, but... Anyway, that's what we get.
Well, yeah, you want to just take a look at it. If I've done some savings, I will probably be in the same tax bracket or a little bit higher. So that's why the tax planning is so a key component of your overall plan. We're going to talk about that in just a couple of minutes. One last thing. If you want to ever get more information and education versus a half an hour, I do a six-hour retirement planning course all over San Diego and also off in Orange County. Just a few nights a week. It's 3 hours one night. It concludes 3 hours the next. If you ever want to get more information on attending one of these classes, you get a 250-page textbook. You can go to our website at purefinancial.com, purefinancial.com. Again, what the purpose of that and this show and everything else that we're doing is trying to get information, education, so that you can make the best decisions possible. We're talking about roadblocks today. When people are approaching retirement, the number one roadblock is a lot of people don't necessarily set the appropriate goals. What do I want to accomplish? When do I want to retire? How much money do I want to spend? You have to write this stuff down so then you can get a roadmap or a game plan in place to say, okay, well, here's what I need to do. Second thing is that there's a lack of knowledge. So people don't necessarily want to seek professional assistance, and I totally understand that, but you still want to get the basis down. How much money should you be saving? What's the tax situation going to be when you do retire? Do you have enough? Right? And then people are getting into inappropriate investments. So what we mean by that is that, okay, well, what investments are you in? Right now, the markets are at all-time highs, and so people are following the herd. They're trying to get into stocks to continue to go with the flow. Be careful with that. Now, is it time for a correction? We're seeing some volatile markets here. So is the market going to pull back? Yes, it will pull back. I just don't know when. If you're in retirement, approaching retirement, you have to have the appropriate strategy. You want to make sure that you have the appropriate investments geared towards your specific goals, not your neighbors, not your friends, not your coworkers, not your brother or sister, your specific situation. And then finally, we're going to get into taxes. Now, taxes, in our opinion, will be one of the biggest expenses that you'll pay in retirement, and it's figuring out what tax planning strategies that you should do.
Yeah, absolutely, Joe. And when you're thinking about taxes, you really need to consider what tax bracket you're in right now versus what tax bracket you're going to be in later. Because a lot of you are going to be in a higher bracket in retirement than you thought because of this required distribution, because of pensions, because of investment income, and the like. And when it comes to taxes, you want to take a look at where your assets are located, whether they're in retirement accounts, which are subject to ordinary income, whether they're tax-free, like municipal bonds, Roth IRAs, or whether they're taxable accounts that could be subject to capital gains. Now, distribution planning is all about figuring out how much to take from your retirement account, which is the highest of tax rates, and then how much to take out of the non-retirement accounts, which could be tax-free, or could be capital gain rates, which are a lot lower.
And as you talk about that, and continue on, because I'll just diagram it a little bit on what people should look at. When you're talking about taxation, when it comes to your overall retirement accounts and then the distributions coming out, is that there's really three different pools of money that you can draw from. And I have the eraser on, so let's see if I can fix that. So we got a couple of different things here. All right, I'm getting pretty good at this, Al.
Yeah, you are.
All right,
looks,
so you got tax-free money. That's TF, tax-free. You got taxable money, and you have tax-deferred. This is the big problem that we're seeing right now, the tax-deferred accounts, because that's your IRAs, your 401ks, your 403bs, your TSPs, the defined benefit plans. This is where the bulk of the savings for you baby boomers right now, last count, $21 trillion are sitting in these accounts, $21 trillion. And the IRS is salivating. They are so excited for you to start drawing these monies out, for you to start making mistakes, for you to reach 70 and a half, because that's judgment day. That's when they're going to get their taxes. You have to look at some strategies to get some of this money out, to get it up here into a tax-free position potentially. Now you have control over your taxes long term. This will save you tens, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars long term if you do this correctly. Of course, it's gonna be different for everyone. I'm looking at generalities here, but what I wanna get across to you is that the traditional view of planning is gone. You have to throw it out the window. You have to get a new perspective of what you're doing with your money. The last thing you want to do is procrastinate, all right? That's the last flaw. That's the last roadblock. Do not procrastinate when it comes to this. Get some help. Get some advice. Figure out what you need to do. Work with someone that's not selling your products. Work with someone that can help you identify the true strategies. If you want, use a fee-only financial advisor. That's our advice. If you want to use us, that's great. Here's the number one last time, 888-994-6257. That's 888-994-6257. That is it for us today. Thanks so much for tuning in. For Big Al Clopine, I'm Joe Anderson. Have a wonderful weekend, everyone. It's a gas.